Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about scientific notation today, and in this video we're talking about multiplying and dividing with scientific notation. If you take science classes, you're going to need to perform operations in scientific notation. You can use your calculator to do these problems, but your instructor may or may not allow you to use a calculator, so let's work them out without a calculator. Here's the examples that I'm going to complete on this video, so you can kind of see ahead of time if it's something that you want to look at. First, remember the commutative property that tells us that if we change the order of the multiplication, we can change the order of a multiplication problem without changing the answer. And in general, we say A times B is the same as B times A. So in this problem, 4 times 10 to the 17th power times negative 2 times 10 to the negative 24th power, what this really says is 4 times 10 to the 17th times negative 2 times 10 to the negative 24th. That it's just one long string of multiplication. When in between the parentheses symbols, we assume a multiplication, and the x here means multiply, so we're just multiplying everything, and so we can use that commutative property, and we can rearrange it to look like this. I'm going to put my integers together, n and negative 2, or 4 and negative 2, sorry, and my powers of 10 together, 10 to the 7th and 10 to the negative 24th. All right, so 10 to the 17th and 10 to the negative 24th, those go together. And so I can simplify the integers, and then I can simplify the powers of 10, and you could try that on your own first before I reveal it, but what you're going to get is 8 times negative 2, which is negative 8, 4 times negative 2, which is negative 8, and then you get 10 to the 17th and 10 to the negative 24th. When you have the same base and you have powers, you add them together. So I'm going to say 17 plus negative 24, and that's how I get negative 7. Now, in previous problems or videos, you may have seen that we don't like to leave our answer with a negative exponent. When you're working with scientific notation, that's an exception because we need the negative to tell us whether we would move our decimal point to the left or to the right. So we're okay with negative exponents in scientific notation. Is this in correct scientific notation? In correct scientific notation, the absolute value of this number should be between 1 and 10, which it is, and our power should be some integer, which it is. So this is in correct scientific notation. Let's take a look at the second example. In this one, we're going to multiply 7.1, or two point one times 10 to the 8th and 7.0 times 10 to the 15th. So following the same process that we did in number one, that is applying the commutative property, we can say 2.1 times 7.0 times 10.8 times 10 to the 8th times 10 to the 15th. Now 2.1 times 7 is 14.7, and 8 plus 15 is 23. When I'm doing the powers of 10, I'm just adding those bases together to get that new power. So the question I have then, is this incorrect scientific notation? And what you should be saying is no, because this number is greater than 10, and the number that we end up with here has to be between 1 and 10. But in performing operations, many times we get something that's not, and so then we want to go back and correct it. Obviously, we don't want to write this as a standard form because we'd have 21 zeros in front here, and that would be a pain. We want to keep scientific notation, we just want to get it into the correct form. So what you should see here is that this would be between 1 and 10 if I had 1.47. And then, because I move my decimal point one place, I also have to change my power by 1. And if I want you to remember the rules that we talked about in previous videos, if you move the decimal to the right, you subtract 1 from the power. And if you move the decimal point to the left, you add 1 to the power. So we just moved our decimal to the left. Since we moved to the left, we should be adding 1 to 23 to get 24. Think about it this way. We were going to take 23 steps to the right, and we backed up. So we actually added a step on. So we have to then add that number onto our power. Okay, Let's look at the other two examples as promised. The first one is a division problem. They're both division problems, but they have different things that I want to show you. So remember the type of problem from before where you have 10x squared over 5x, and we could simplify the coefficients and the variables separately. So we could say 10 over 5 is 2, and then we have more x's on top, so we get x. We can simplify that because we have factors. 10 and x squared are factors, and 5 and x are factors. In the same way, we can simplify the scientific notation problem because these things are factors. They're being multiplied. We're using an x, but it still means multiplication. So let's see how I would rewrite that. I would rewrite that as the 8.2 over 4.1 and then times this, because up here when I simplified, my final answer was, you can't see it now, is 2 times x. So I'm going to simplify those, and I want to warn you because the powers of 10, that's a trouble spot for students when you're simplifying that, so be careful. I think you can see that what's going to happen is we're going to get negative 7 because we're dividing. It's negative 7 minus negative 3, which is actually plus 3, which gives us 10 to the negative 4th. And also you can see that 8.2 divided by 4.1 is 2, so we have 2 times 10 to the 4th power. My question for you is this incorrect scientific notation? This number is between 1 and 10, so yes. This is an integer, so yes. Remember, it's okay to have negative exponents, so yes, that's incorrect scientific notation. All right, what about this one? We can do the same thing using the same thing from example 3. So we're going to rewrite that as thinking about the numbers, the n, and then the powers of 10. You might want to try this one on your own and see what you get. Final answer all the way through. Then come back and check. Well, maybe you got this 0.5 because 4 over 8 is 0.5. And then 10 to the 13th. Maybe you got 10 to the 3rd, which you really want to be careful, because this is 10 to the 8th minus negative 5. And you're adding 5 there, so you get 13th. So this should have been where you headed, but it shouldn't have been your last step, because it's not incorrect scientific notation, because this number is not between 1 and 10. So what is the final correct answer? Well, the final correct answer, you should be moving your decimal point 1 to the right. And if you move to the right, what do? Do you add or subtract? If you don't remember, then I'll tell you, if you're here, you were going to move 13 places to the right and you take one of those steps. So you're actually subtracting. If you move to the right, you subtract 1. So your final answer should have been 5.0 times 10 to the 12th. Why did I put the 0 in there? Because we had one decimal point in our problem, so in our answer, I want to have the same thing. Now, if you are interested in how to do these kind of problems on your calculator, well, it's always great to be able to do things on your calculator, but remember, you may not always be allowed to use a calculator. And you have a different calculator than I do, so if this one is not your calculator, then just go on YouTube and say scientific notation on, and then put in the type of calculator that you have. Let's do this first one. I'm going to do 4, and then I'm going to push this EE button. That's telling me that I'm doing scientific notation. And then I'm going to say 17. And then I'm going to multiply that times negative 2 times to the negative 24th power. And that's giving me negative 8. See how I've got all those zeros in there? I want to change that. I don't really want that to be in that kind of notation. I would rather it be in scientific notation. But at least you can check your answer. If it has a bunch of more zeros, it would actually give it to you in scientific notation. What did we get for an answer? We got negative 8 times 10 to the negative 7th, which is what I have here. Let's try this one where we had 10 to the 24th, because your calculator can't handle that many zeros. When it gets to the point where it can't handle zeros, it's going to put it in scientific notation. So 2.1 EE to the 8th times 7.0 EE to the 15th. Now this one, they're going to leave it in scientific notation because they're not going to trail 24 zeros on there. When you see the E, that means, remember what our answer was? Our answer was 1.47 times 10 to the 24th. So this is what the problem looks like on your calculator. So you have to be able to translate it into correct format. And if you put on the test this and E24, I'll know that what your calculator said. That's not the correct way to write scientific notation for us. Okay, have a fantastic day.